Okay, I want to go to Revelations. Thank you for coming back. This is Revelations Visions, part 3. And this should be the final part to what I'm telling you today about the dream that I had, okay? Now, what I want to do is go ahead and read Revelations chapter 9. I had told you 1 through 4, but I'm going to go a little bit further on that because I want you to get the severity of what is told right now. Okay. So it says, "And the fifth angel sounded, and I saw a star fall from heaven unto the earth, and to him was given the key of the bottomless pit. And he opened the bottomless pit, and there arose the smoke out of the pit, and the smoke of the great furnace, and the sun. And the air was darkened by reason of the smoke of the pit. And there came out smoke locusts upon the earth, and unto was given power, and the scorpions, as the scorpions of the earth have power." I'm sorry, apologize. "And it was commanded them that they should not hurt the grass of the earth, neither any green thing, neither any tree, but only those men who do not have the seal of God on their foreheads." That's the vision that God was giving me about the massive size insects that I was seeing. And I said I never saw anything like that before. Okay, but also don't get it wrong or twisted when it comes to the rest, what I was reading, to what I'm about to read to you now. I'm on verse 5 of Revelation 9. "And to them was given that they should not kill them, but that they should be tormented 5 months. And their torment was the torment of a scorpion when he striketh a man." That's a lot of pain. Okay. "And in those days shall men seek death and shall not find it, and it shall desire to die, and death shall flee from them." I was letting you know that their blood and everything is going to be tainted, or however it's going to mess with them. They're going to be in a lot of pain, and they're going to suffer a lot. But for some reason why, they just had to suffer. They wasn't dying. Okay. Now, and the shapes of the locusts. Now, this is where this is soldiers and machines. Okay. But you have to understand, John was explaining it in his time. He could not let you know what machines he was seeing, okay? Now, this and the shapes and the locusts were like unto horses preparing unto battle. And on their heads were, as it was, crowns like gold, and faces were as the faces of men. Okay. You are talking about tanks. We are talking about soldiers that they literally, so you're talking about helicopters that they have faces painted on them, okay, with the teeth, sharp teeth and everything. I haven't seen this before, okay. You are also talking about like horses. They have the machines, you know how they ride and they be going and it's ta-da-da-da-da-da-da, okay. That's why he was like, it was like me, because he had to try to explain. And you have the tankers, okay, the tanks that, and this is part where I'm going to show you, these are tanks, okay. And they had hair as hair of women, and their teeth were as teeth of lions, the faces on the helicopter. Okay, so let me let you know that. Okay, and they had breastplates as if they were breastplates of iron, and the sounds of their wings was as, I'm turning the page, people, the sounds of chariot of many horses running into battle. We know what they sound like when they start up, the choppers, okay? And they had tails like unto scorpions, and they were to sting in their tails and had the powers to hurt men 5 months. They have the authority of the Antichrist, okay, to go out and hurt anybody that will not take his seal, okay? That will not take his seal, okay? And the prince of darkness. So you have to understand that. Now the end of a helicopter looks like what? A tail. And when they had that thing on the back of it, looks like what? A scorpion's tail. Yes. You see it now? You understand? This is what God was giving to me. Okay? He was giving this to me. Also, I want to go ahead and read to you verse 11. "And they had a king." Remember what I just told you, the Antichrist? And they had a king over them, which is the angel of the bottomless pit, whose name in Hebrew's tongue is Abaddon. Okay? But the Greek tongue had his name Apollyon. I might be pronouncing that wrong. I do apologize that I get a little tired tongue, but again, read it for yourself. Now, one woe has passed, and behold, there came two woes more thereafter. And the sixth angel sounded, and I heard a voice from the four horns of the golden altar, which is before God, saying to the sixth angel which had the trumpet, loose the four angels which are bound in the great river. Your parrites. I'm sorry. Euphrates. I do apologize for my pronunciation. And the four angels were loosed, which were prepared for an hour and a day and a month and a year for to slay a third part of man. And the number of the army of the horsemen were 200,000. And I heard the number of them. And I saw the horses in the vision, and them that sat on them having breastplates of fire, and of jacinth, and a breaststone, and the head of the horses were as the head of lions, and out of their mouth, here we go, the tanks, out of their mouth issued fire and smoke and brimstone. You have to understand the smell of ammunition. They use sulfur in it, okay? That's a fact. Look it up for yourself. You know that. You should have learned it in school, okay? And it smells horrific. Gunfire stinks, okay? But this is coming out of the tankers. And when it shoots out, boom! Boom! You're not going to survive that blow. Those are tankers. But again, John had no way to know what they are in today's time. He had to explain what it looked like to him. So if you're really looking at big giant lions coming out and spilling fire out their mouth, he just letting you know the aggressiveness of that particular machine. Because lions are known. They're not, put like this here, you're not going to put a big old lion in your house, you're not going to pet it, and it's going to be your pet. Okay? So the tankers are not there to be your friend. Okay? So, verse 19. For their power is in their mouth and in their tail. For their tails were like scorpions and had heads with them that do hurt. So you know you're going to get hurt with these weapons, machinery, war weapons, okay? And the rest of the men which were not killed by these plagues, yet repented not of the works of their hand, and they should not worship devils, idols of gold and silver, and brass and stone and of wood, which neither can see nor hear nor walk. So you have things like Buddha, Hinduism, you have the Muslims, you have all these things. You're worshiping idols, statues, you know, things that you cannot should not worship, because our God is a jealous God. Okay? So we're not supposed to have these idol things. But yet, they did not repent. Okay? Even the ones that were spared anyway, they still didn't repent. Okay? So, woe be unto them. Okay? Neither repented they of their murders. Okay? Remember the vision that he gave me of the judgment. Nor of their sorceries, nor of their fornication, nor of their theft. Now, I'm in verse 10. I'm in chapter 10, I'm sorry. And I saw another mighty angel come down from heaven, clothed with a cloud and a rainbow upon his head, and his face was as it was the sun, and his feet was like pillars of fire. And he had in his hand a little book open, and he set it on the right foot upon the sea, and the left foot of the earth. And he cried out with a loud voice, and when the lion roared, and when he cried out, seven thunders uttered their voices. And when the seven thunders uttered their voices, I was about to write, and I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, seal up those things which the seven thunders uttered, and do not write them. And the angel which I saw standing upon the sea and upon the earth lifted up his hands up into heaven, okay, and swore by him that liveth forever and ever, who created heaven and the things thereof, and the earth and the things that was therein are, the sea and the things which are thereof therein, that there should be time no longer. There should be a delay in time. But in the days of the voice of the seventh angel, when he shall begin to sound, and the mystery of God should be finished, as it hath declared unto his servants the prophets. And the voice which I have heard from heaven spake unto me again, and said, go and take the little book which is open, and the hand of the angel which standing upon the earth and the sea. And I went upon the angel and said unto him, give me the little book. And he said unto me, take it and eat it, and it shall make my belly bitter, but it shall be in thy mouth sweet as honey. And this is where I read 10 and 11 to you earlier. And it said, and I took the little book out of the angel's hand and ate it up, and it was sweet. And then it was in my mouth sweet as honey. And as soon as I eaten it, it made my belly bitter. And he said unto me, thou must prophesy again before many peoples and nations and the tongue of the king. Okay, so I just want to let you guys, this is the six angels have blown, and you had the first woe. Okay, I have not yet got to the other woes. There were three woes, and they are more tremendous than the first. They are more tremendous than the first angel blew. But when I give you that seventh trumpet blowing, I hope it wake you up, people, because you don't want to get caught up in it. You want to be on God's side. And I hope this touched someone's heart. I pray that it does. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that it touches your heart, that it changes your mind. You do not want to spend eternity being tortured. God never made hell for man. He made hell for Satan, the demons, and the fallen angels. He never intended it for to be us, because he loves us way too much. For those who say God does not exist, woe be unto you. And I hope you change your mind, and I hope you do anything to get you to come on the Lord's side. For those who straddling the fish, saying I love the Lord, but I don't want to give up worldly things, either you for me or you against me, is what God said. Because even you, as mortal man, don't want anyone in your face playing both sides of the street, because it hurts. And imagine what it does to God. So I hope you turn from your wicked ways, repent, call upon God, and watch what he do for you. Be blessed. I will come to you and give you the last series of this. But again, I want you to be blessed. Stay encouraged. And peace be unto you. I love you. Have a blessed day.